ascended into heaven. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints.
The Lord be with you.
Thank you. If the Lord had not been on our side, let Israel say,
if the Lord had not been on our side, when men attacked us,
when their anger flared against us, they would have swallowed us alive.
The fire would have engulfed us, the torrent would have swept over us.
In the raging waters would have swept us away.
Praise be to the Lord, who has not let us be torn by their teeth.
We have escaped like a bird out of the Pharaoh's snare, the snare that has been broken, and we have escaped.
Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
First Kings, chapter 38, 1 to 11. Then the Lord answered God out of the stone. He said, who is this that darkens my counsel with words without knowledge? Raise yourself like a man. I will question you, and you shall answer me. Where were you when I gave the earth foundation? Tell me, if you understand, who marked off its dimensions? Surely you know who stretched a million line across it. On what where its footing set, or who laid its cornerstone? While the morning stars stand together, and all the angels shouted for joy, who shut up the sea behind those when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment and wrapped it in thick darkness, when I fixed limits for it and set its doors and bars in place, then I said, this is this far you may come, and no further. Here is where your proud waves part. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Picture St. Paul's second letter to Corinthians, chapter 6, 1 to 13. As God's fellow workers, we urge you not to receive God's grace in vain. For he said, in the time of my favor I heard you, or in the day of salvation I help you. I tell you, now is the time of God's favor. Now is the day of salvation. We put no stumbling block in anyone's path, so that our mystery will not be discredited. Rather, as servants of God, we commend ourselves in every way, in great endurance, in troubles, hardships, and distresses, in beatings, imprisonments, and riots, in hard work, sleepless nights, and hunger, in theory, understanding, patience, and kindness, in the Holy Spirit, and in sincere love. In truthful speech, and in the power of God, with weapons of righteousness, in the right hand, and in the left, to glory and honor. Bad report and good report, genuine, yet regarded as impartial, known, yet regarded as unknown, dying and yet believer, beaten and yet not killed, sorrowful yet always enjoying poor, yet making many rich, and nothing and yet possessing everything, We have spoken freely to you, Corinthians, and opened wide our hearts to you. You are not withholding our affection from you, but you are withholding yours from us. At the fair exchange, I speak as to my children, open wide your hearts also. This is the word of God.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the 4th chapter, beginning at the 35th verse. Let us go over to the other side. Leaving the crowd behind, they took him along just as he was in the boat. There were also other boats with him. A furious squall came up, and the waves broke over the boat so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciples woke him and said to him, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" He got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down, and it was completely calm. He said to his disciples, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" They were terrified and asked each other, "Who is this? Even the wind and the waves obey him." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, O Christ.
The congregation may be seated. I'm going to put my mask on because I'm going to stop moving around here. I don't want to offend anyone. And as I do, they're way ahead of me. That's great. All right, come on down. Okay, beautiful.
God did something only He could do, and He loves us that much. We never have to worry about it. I'm going to talk to Mom and Dad in a little while about that. But let's just take a moment to pray. I'll let you get on to Sunday school. We're going to learn more about God who loves you and cares for you more than you will ever know. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for sending Jesus.
Thank you for sending Jesus
to be our Savior.
To be our Savior.
To show us how much you love us.
Show us how much you love us.
And how much you care.
And how much you care.
Be with us always wherever we go.
Be with us always wherever we go.
Keep us in your almighty care.
Keep us in your almighty care.
That we may also love you.
That we may also love you.
And love others the way you love us.
And love others the way you love us.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thanks for coming. Happy birthday to all of you celebrating birthdays. Have fun with the race cars. And keep an eye out for the rainbow. All right. That's all for Tony. Tony, sit back there on the ground. Okay, just take the message from the audience. Okay. Talk to him about rainbows.
Well, wherever the sun is, after it rains, look the opposite way to see the rainbow. So if the sun is over here in the afternoon, look towards the east to see the rainbow. That's where it'll always be, opposite the sun.
How about that? I know that. See? You learn something new every day. Look the other way. There's the rainbow. I can take this off now, right?
Yes.
I'm standing still. Standing still. Okay. Before I forget, Happy Father's Day.
Thank you. Happy Father's Day.
You too.
Thank you. Thank you. I always say, people come out of church, I shake hands, mothers, kids, Happy Father's Day. Well, I'm not a father, but that's okay. You can have a good day too. It is Father's Day, and we're all celebrating. And after all, as someone said to me this morning, you know, we all have fathers. Had fathers, we would be here if we didn't have a father. And we certainly have our Heavenly Father to thank for the blessings we have. Earlier, I had shared with the congregation, even though it wasn't as many as we've had in the past, and here again, some people are missing, and I thought, well, should I share this little ditty about golfing? And there were a few golfers. I don't know if we have any golfers in this group. We do have some golfers upstairs. Okay, and we have golfers here, so not all the golfers on Father's Day are out golfing. That's good to know. Often enough on Father's Day, golfers go golfing rather than coming to church. Now don't be surprised, I have to admit that there are some Sundays that I actually pray for rain. This isn't one of them. This isn't one of them. But the top 10. David Letterman. David Letterman used to have the top 10 jokes or stories or whatever. Well, this is the top 10 list of caddy comments. Caddy comments. Number 10. We start at the highest. Number 10. Golfer. Think I'm going to drown myself in the lake. Caddy, think you can keep your head down that long? Number 9, golfer, I'd move heaven and earth to break up 100 on this course. Caddy, try heaven. You've already moved most of the earth. Number 8, you think my game is improving? Caddy, oh, yes, sir. You missed the ball much closer now. Number 7, do you think I can get there with a 5-iron? Caddy, eventually. Number 6, golfer, you've got to be the worst caddy in the world. Caddy, I don't think so, sir. That would be too much of a coincidence. Number 5, golfer, please stop checking your watch all the time. It's too much of a distraction. Caddy, it's not a watch, sir. It's a compass.
Oh, geez.
Number 4, golfer, how do you like my game? Caddy, well, very good, sir, but personally, I prefer golf. Number 3, golfer, do you think it's a sin to play on Sunday? Caddy, the way you play, sir, it's a sin any day. Number 2, golfer, this is the worst course I've ever played on. Caddy, this isn't the golf course, sir. We left that an hour ago. And number 1 best caddy comment, golfer, that can't be my ball. It's too old. Caddy, it's been a long time, sir, since we teed off. Well, that's one for the golfers here and the golfers who aren't here. All right. Another story, more appropriate to our text for the day, about a Father Demetrius, true story, a priest of the Orthodox Eastern Rite Church. Father Demetrius was a good, strong Christian man. Like so many others in the Orthodox Church, he was a man for whom the prayer of Jesus was very important, a man who had been graced with a special talent for teaching other people, to enrich their lives through prayer He was a man who cared deeply about other people, a man who was much loved by the people he ministered to in the city. And one day, a tragic riot occurred in the city, causing extensive damage to property. One family lost all its possessions, the family dwelling, the family business, the furniture, clothing, everything they had was destroyed. Friends and family provided assistance, of course, and so did Father Demetrius. He volunteered to help the youngest daughter in the family, who appeared to be especially in need. Father Demetrius lived a very frugal life, but he did have some money. The girl needed shoes, stockings, a dress, a coat. Father Demetrius bought all these things for her, and then with the remaining money, he bought her a ring. When the people in the community heard about it, they began to talk about him behind his back. How foolish it was of him to buy her a ring. He's a good man, a loving person, but he's so naive. To buy a ring at a time like this, in this situation? Demetrius happened to overhear some of their talk, their comments, and he said very quietly, "I wanted to give her something that not only would remind her of her poverty and her loss, but that would also help her to know that she is loved. Something to remind her that she's loved." Our text is all about this morning. God's love for us in our most dire need and our dire times of life. In the midst of life's burdens, we bear so much in our lives. We still wrestle with the COVID virus. And that's why the leaders of our church here have decided to implement a policy, simply put, to follow the CDC guidelines, list on the bulletin board, on the door coming in. You got a copy of it in your bulletin today. Keeping it simple, but caring about everyone. After some changes were made last week, I understand there were some comments that came back, questions, issues, and okay, trying to please everybody can be a difficult thing to do. The leadership, I believe, is doing a fantastic job putting it together, keeping it together, trying to help everybody. It's not easy. We're going through a difficult time, but trying to keep it simple so that everyone benefits and no one gets hurt. And wearing masks, of course, nobody wants to do that. We'd like to get out of that as soon as possible. The CDC has made changes, continues to make changes for everyone's benefit. And keeping it simple, yes, if people have been vaccinated, not if they have, we don't have any studies. The CDC doesn't have the studies in the background to say anything beyond that. What they have are vaccines, they have the tests, and they can say and have said, if you've been vaccinated, then you don't have to wear the mask. But for everyone's benefit here at Grace, we've decided that we're just going to wear masks, everybody, when we move around. When we move around, you stand, if you sit in a certain place, okay, if you haven't been vaccinated, the CDC says you're supposed to wear a mask, and so that's the policy that we're following, and we encourage that. We're not going to be on top of somebody or on anybody's case here, but we are going to say, hey, yeah, that is the policy we're following. Whether everybody follows that or not, we defer to God's people. So you should be wearing a mask if you haven't received the vaccine. Not easy. We continue to wrestle. We wrestle with so many things in homes and families. People wonder at times, where is God? The disciples wondered where the Lord was as they faced a very dire situation. They were out on a boat, out on a lake, when a squall came up, a furious squall, known to happen in that part of the world, in that particular lake, where Jesus said, let's go over to the other side, and he went along with them. They took him to the other side. Interesting, mind-boggling. I don't know about you, but I've been in boats that have had some squalls at times, and I didn't sleep through. I don't know. You ever had? I was talking to Dave Anderson this morning, and Billy wasn't here. Billy's here now, and frankly, these guys go out usually on a nice day, but it's not always nice coming back. And sometimes they get caught in a storm. And Dave was telling me he's had some pretty wild experiences. I'm sure Bill's had some too. And the disciples were out with Jesus in the boat. Waves broke over the boat so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. Can you imagine? Now, there's a story about the story. It actually happened a few years back. You may recall that there was a young man who had a problem with sleepwalking. I don't know if anybody here has that problem, or you've known of anybody who's had that problem, but this guy, this happened in New York City, Bronx, Brooklyn, one of the boroughs. He was sleepwalking in his apartment, third floor. You can imagine what happened. He walked out a window. You've got to be kidding. He was sound asleep. By the grace of God, he not only fell three stories down, but he landed on an awning that was out from the building. He landed right on top of the awning. The awning didn't break. He kind of rolled off. Got back on the ground, looked around and wondered, how did I get here? Yeah. Amazing, he lived, he was fine. He woke up, needless to say. Well, I guess people can sleep through some pretty serious situations. The disciples were a bit concerned because Jesus was sleeping on a cushion, of course. The King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Lord of all creation. He wasn't worried, but they were. The disciples woke him up, said to him, Teacher, don't you care if we drown? Are you kidding? Don't you care? God's people may think that at times. We drown. We may think we're so overwhelmed with life, we can't handle it anymore. I've had people say that to me in the hospital. They just want to die. They just want to die. Is that wrong? Pastor, is it wrong to want to die and go to heaven and be with the Lord? And I have to say, no. Nothing wrong with that. We all have a desire, as St. Paul said, to depart and be with the Lord, which is a far better thing. But as Paul said, it's far better for your sake that I remain. And what we have to accept is that God is God. He's in control of our lives, whether we know it or not. And we have to wait until the time that he has determined when it's time to be with him in our heavenly home and with all those who've gone on before us. And we know, yes, we are going to see many loved ones that have gone on before us. But Jesus is Lord. And we have to let go and let God. We are constantly overwhelmed. The world is too much with us, as someone once said. And we say, Lord, don't you care? Don't you care? My marriage is on the rocks, and I've done all that I can do to keep it together. I don't know where to go, what to do. Lord, don't you care? Don't you care that my son, my daughter, is out of control, hooked on drugs? I'm trying everything in my power to help them. Don't you care? My friends in school say mean, nasty things about me. I try to be a friend. Are they really my friends? They put things on the internet that are devastating. Don't you care? Don't you care that the golden years aren't as golden as we thought they were? Now I have to have a test done. The doctor's report is not good. And I have to have surgery. And I don't know where it's going to end, how it's going to end. Lord, don't you care? We're drowning here. Teacher, don't you care if we drown? We come together today and every day and every week and worship a God who cares more than we could ever know. God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And I believe that life starts here and now through faith in the one who gave his life for us. Greater love, Jesus said, has no one than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I desire, what I command. Care? Our God cares for us more than we could ever imagine. There are times when we think he doesn't hear us, times we think he's not going to answer us. And then we come and we sing hymns that were perfect. I got to tell you, the songs, you guys picked songs that just fit so perfectly. A God who loves us, a God who cares so much. He hears, he helps, he saves, he has saved us. I've said so many times, if God doesn't answer your prayer exactly what you're asking, when you want it, when you need it most, believe me, he's got a better plan. He's got something else he wants you to have. I can't tell you what it is. He knows the future. He knows what's best for us. He's got a plan. All things work together for good, right? For good to those who love God and are called according to his purpose. He has a plan. People ask us, God, do you think God micromanages everything? God is in control of everything. Are you kidding me? Does he know? Yeah. Has he got a plan? Yes. And everything happens for good, works together for good to those who love him and are called according to his purpose, according to his plan. I can't tell you what it is. That's what faith is all about. To let go and let God. And if God says no, it's only because he's got a better plan. And we need to wait and see. Lord, don't you care? Teacher, don't you care if we drop? Care? He got up, he rebuked the wind, said to the waves, quiet, be still. And the wind died down, and it was completely calm. And Jesus said to his disciples, why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith? It all comes down to letting go and letting God, and having faith in him. Let me close by sharing with you another story. Just enough time to tell you the story. I don't believe I've shared this with you before. It's simply entitled, When Your Hut's on Fire. It's a key, let me tell you. The only survivor of a shipwreck was washed up on a small, uninhabited island.
He prayed feverishly for God to rescue him. Every day he scanned the horizon for help, but none seemed forthcoming. Exhausted, he eventually managed to build a little hut out of driftwood to protect him from the elements and to store his few possessions. One day, after scavenging for food, he arrived home to find his little hut in flames, with smoke rolling up to the sky. He felt the worst had happened. Everything was lost. He was stunned beyond disbelief, grief, anger. He cried out, "God, how could you do this to me?" Early the next day, he was awakened by the sound of a ship approaching the island. It had come to rescue him. "How did you know I was here?" the weary man asked. "We saw your smoke signal," they replied. "We saw your smoke signal." The moral of the story? It's easy to get discouraged when things are going bad, but we shouldn't lose heart, because God is at work in our lives, even in the midst of our pain and our suffering. Remember, the next time your little hut seems to be burning to the ground, it just may be a smoke signal that summons the grace of God. Our God is a God who loves and cares more than we could ever imagine. Teacher, don't you care if we drown? God is covered. You're not drowning. God was in Christ, reconciled, bringing together the world, reconciling the world to himself, and giving to us that ministry of reconciliation, of telling others of the great things our God has done. May this be the faith we ever have in him, faith strengthened by his word, the sacrament of his body and blood, given and shed for the forgiveness of all our sin. May this be the faith we ever have, we ever live, we ever share, as we also share the love of God with one another. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Now and forever. We say, pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Our sins unto God our Father, asking him in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to grant us forgiveness. Our help is in the name of the Lord. I said I will confess my sins unto the Lord.
And
you
forgave
me for my sin. O Almighty God, merciful Father, I have your miserable sin. Confess unto you all my sins and iniquities, with which I have ever offended you, and justly deserve your temporal and eternal punishment. But I am heartily sorry for them, and sincerely repent for them. And I pray you in your boundless mercy, and in the safety of the holy, innocent, bitter sufferings and death of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be gracious and merciful to me, a poor sinful. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
same night on which he was betrayed took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." After the same manner also he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." As often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.
You may be seated.
And we implore you that of your mercy you would strengthen us through the same in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Now receive the benediction of the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Thank you.
video's on the...
Now.
Okay? Thank you.